What is going on, YouTube? Parker here. And today it's time for another Budget Duel 12 setup. We've got the Def Bonds Machete Light R subs over here. So these guys are under 100 bucks a piece. It was like 180 for both of these. So let's get these out, check them out, and see how they do. Here's the owner's manual. Here's the recommended box tuning. And here are the specs for the 10-inch and the 12-inch. Of course, we have the 12-inch, so let's see what we got here. We have a pressed paper cone, stamped steel basket, ferrite motor, 500 watts RMS, 1000 max, 2-inch voice copper voice coil. The sensitivity is 88 dB. Frequency response is 38 hertz. And the BL is 16.6. And here is the sub. For being under $100 sub, this guy actually doesn't look too bad. Okay, here are the subs. Let's take a look at these guys. Of course, got the Machete logo up here. And of course, this is a pressed paper cone. It is definitely not stiff at all, but what you would expect for a $90 sub. Of course, we do have a pretty half-decent looking motor on this thing with a nice boot over it, so does look pretty cool. You know, Def Bonds does go above and beyond with all their stuff, so nice to see that. We do have a mid-roll surround, no stitching around there if you care about that. We of course have pretty small leads. We have pretty small terminals, but again, for $80 sub, they seem pretty standard. Not quite as bad as the last sub I did, but they are pretty small. You can see that 2-inch coil in there. And then again, this is a half decent looking motor for the price. So yeah, overall not too bad, guys, but let's throw this in my box and put it in the car and get to testing. Okay guys, got these fellas hooked up in the car. Super excited about this. Now, at the time of me filling this, Down for Sound has these on sale for a tax day sale thing that they got going on. So I will leave a link in the description below. Of course, there'll be an affiliate link, but if you want to check these out or some other stuff, they have a bunch of stuff with their tax day sale, so go check that out.
Thank you.
Y'all, if you want some budget dual 12s, these guys are awesome. Very, very happy with these. If you're on a budget, but you do want to get some decent volume, 212s is the way to go. You're going to get so much more bang for the buck with 212s as opposed to one. And y'all, these things are kicking butt. So let's go ahead and do the musical RMS test. Just make sure they are good at that 500 watts a piece. So 1,000 watts. See if it makes it through a full song. And then we can really get to pushing these guys. As I expected, made it through that. Absolutely no problem. Not really even warm, guys. With some of their other more high-end subs, I put them through a 5-minute non-stop 40 hertz test dome at the RMS power, and it made it through that fine as well. One of the subs made it through totally fine. The other one made it all the way through, and then when I turned it off, I turned it off too quick. Didn't let the air keep moving, so it did fry one of the coils. But hey, guys, these fellas are doing good. All right, let's see how loud we can get these guys. I've got them facing the back, so we're gonna play a test tune through it just to see kind of where this peaks at, and then we'll go up from there. Okay, 131, 45 hertz, that seems about right to me. And 41 hertz. 34.7, 43 hertz. Okay, average out of the three is 43 hertz, so that's what we're gonna start at and see what we get. 43 hertz, let's go. 868 watts, got a 137, not bad. 1346 watts, and it says 136. Okay, 2180 watts, and we got a 138. 3,500 watts, but only a 137.9. Try it again, see what happens. Maxing out there, 5,458 watts. But there it is, guys. We broke into that 140. We're gonna turn it up again. Hopefully nothing breaks. 500 at 215 watts. And again, a 140.6. Let's try 45 hertz just to see if that makes a difference. 4,747 watts and 139, so nope, that did not help. Okay, let's try 41 hertz, see what that does. 5,361 watts. Ah, that helped. Broke up into a 141. Just for the heck of it, let's try 40 hertz. 5,476 watts and a 139.6. Well, guys, a 141 out of two super budget 12s in a prefab box. I'm not going to complain about that too much, guys. Very happy with it. And the subs seem to hold on. No dust caps blew off or anything like that. Okay, let's play some music through it, turn it up a little bit, and just see what this thing can take. Well, guys, these fellas have been troopers. They have done well. Very, very happy with them. Again, anything Def Bonds has really impressed me. And once again, for a budget setup, guys, this is totally something I would do if I was on a under $200 budget for some subs. So go grab you a decent, you know, prefab box or make you box if you got time for that. Go get you these subs. You'll be happy. Remember to check out Down for Sound. See if they still have any of these guys left. Anyway, my overall opinions, these are tough subs. They sound good. They get the job done. No, they don't smash the lows like a $500 sub is going to do or anything like that. But hey, they're tough. They sound good. They seem to be well made. And they took tons of power and had no problems, guys. Anyway, that's going to do it for this video. Thank you all so, so much. Let me know what you think. Let me know what budget subs you would have got. And stay tuned for more stuff coming soon. I think we have a bigger 15 next for the channel, guys. So stay tuned for that. Also, if you want to stay tuned to giveaways that I do on the channel, go check the link in the description below to my Facebook page. That's where I do all the giveaways through there. So we'll be picking something else to give away here soon and giving it away on the Facebook page, guys. So go check out that Facebook page. Like that page to be entered for giveaways. And stay tuned.